Hello all and welcome to the webinar, Signature and Demo on New Capabilities. We will first discuss the overview of the current features and then we can have a quick demo of the newest and the cool features which have come into Signature. After the webinar, we have an interesting poll question and I request everyone to answer the same. We will also have a Q&A session at the end of the webinar and you can type in your questions in the chat window for the same. So let us begin with the webinar. Okay, so introducing Signature. Signature is a solution where you can sign documents using multiple types of electronic signatures, digital signatures and biometric signatures. Signature gives you high level of security using the blockchain technology and allows you to sign documents from anywhere in the world using devices like mobile, laptop or computer. It can be used by individuals, by enterprises for processes like API integration. So features overview, if we see the current features, we have the dashboard, statistics, links, alerts, notification. Various types of signing types ranging from electronic, digital to biometric. Biometric including your fingerprint, iris and face. The file formats supported in Signature are PDF, document, DocX, PPT, XLS. Signing process includes setting observer, due dates, notifications, advanced options like setting reminders, etc. We also have a Signature mobile app where you can sign documents using the mobile application anywhere in the world. We have ready APIs for the customers who want to integrate Signature into their systems. A complete audit trail of the signing process is available every time you sign a document, which shows all the signing process happening, like who opened the document, when signed it, which signature was used, the location and everything. The newest feature we have is document verification, where you can verify the document before signing. So if you want to sign a document and you just want to verify whether this was the same document you agreed to sign, you can just verify it. If there's a minute change of a full stop also, the verification process will show you that the document is not the same, and then you can probably see where the document is being tampered with. Another option we have is bulk signing, where you can send a document, a common document, to n number of signers at a time. What's new in this release? So talking about this release, what new features we have in this release? So one most important features we have in this release is self-signing. So self-signing is when you upload a document and you yourself want to sign the document. So you don't need to go through a long process of four steps. You just can sign the document in just simple two or three steps. The next we have is co-signing, where if I'm sending a document to a signer, to let's say two signers, and they both are going to sign the document. So what happens is one signer can just log in and the other can sign the document from his account, the signer one's account. So he just has to go through an OTP process where he gets an OTP on his mobile number, he puts in that and he can sign the document. Next we have is you can reassign the document or decline the document. So if you don't want to sign the document, you can just reassign to somebody from your colleagues or your team. Reusable document templates is where you can define a template with number of signers, number of observers, and the type of signature, and you can reuse the same template again and again. You can just, you know, change the signers and everything. Next we have is restrict signers location. So if you want a particular document to be signed from a particular place, so you can restrict that periphery that the user or the signer will be signing this document from that place only. If the signer is sitting beyond that location, he won't be able to sign the document. Next we have is access other users' documents. So let's say me and one of my colleague, we want to share some documents, then I can just put send him a request for accessing his documents and he can accept it. So I can view his document, I can see his documents. Next we have is AD authentication, wherein you can, you know, log in using your Windows password or your Renova password. So let's go through a quick demo of how these features are working. Okay, so I have logged into my signature account and I will just choose a file here. A demo file, which is a SOW sample. So we'll first go through the self-signing feature, where only if you are only the signer of the document, you yourself can sign the document immediately on the second screen itself. So I'll just select the type of document here. I'll put the document description, the sample SOW. I will select the signers here. So I am myself a signer. Let's say I want this person as a signer and I want another this signer. So I've selected three signers here. I can define the parallel order or the sequential order here. So I'll just save and next. I'll select the electronic signature here. Do save and next. Okay. So on this page where I want the document, the signatures to pop up, I think there's some internet issue, connectivity issue. Just give me a second. Yeah. Okay. So for myself, I'll be signing here. Okay, so that's it. So in just simple one step, my sign comes and pops up. So if even I am the single person who's going to sign this document, I can just do it in the three-step process. I don't need to go review and send the document, again open the application, again sign the document. So that's it. So this is one feature we've come up with. So I want David Hay to sign here and I want Shruti to sign here. So these are two placeholders for these two people. I'll just save and next. So the second feature which we discussed, co-signing feature, which is enable co-signing, sign in person. So if I'm enabling co-sign, I'll just set up a due date and reminder for one day. So if I enable co-sign, now the document goes to David Hay and also Shruti will be able to sign from the David Hay's account itself. So we will see a demo of how that works. I'll just finish it. Okay, so the document is sent. Now I'll log into David Hay's account and here I'm getting a notification. So awaiting my sign, I can see this document here. Okay, so I will just sign now. Okay, so here it is. So click here to click to sign your e-signature. So when I click here, it will ask for David Hay's signature. I'll say done. And now this is some other person. So Shruti Vish is some other person, some other account, but still I will be